At the end of the topic, you will be able to understand the types of farming practice in Tamil Nadu, discuss the cropping seasons of Tamil Nadu. Agriculture is the prime and traditional occupation for the people of Tamil Nadu. The practice of growing plants on a large scale for food and other purposes is known as agriculture. It includes rearing of animals, birds, forestry, fisheries, and other related activities. Types of farming. The methods of growing crops are classified into the following. Subsistence intensive farming. Farming is carried out on small land holdings that produce food crops for local consumption and not for external trade. Plantation farming. Crops are grown on large farms or estates. Tea, coffee, and rubber are grown as plantation crops. Mixed farming. The land is allotted for more than one activity along with agriculture. Mixed farming is common in Kaveri Delta. Market gardening, it includes growing of fruits, vegetables and flowers. Cropping seasons of Tamil Nadu. Farmers select particular crops to be cultivated in a season to suit soil and availability of water in that season. There are three cropping seasons in Tamil Nadu. They are Sornavare, seeds are sown during May and harvested in October. Samba, seeds are sown during July and harvested in January. Navarai, seeds are sown in the month of November and harvested in March. Factors influencing agriculture. Factors influencing agriculture are classified as physical, social, and economic factors. In this topic, you have learned the practice of growing plants on a large scale for food and other purposes is known as agriculture. The methods of growing crops are classified into the following. Subsistence, intensive farming, plantation farming, mixed farming, and market gardening. At the end of the topic, you will be able to understand the sources of irrigation in Tamil Nadu, discuss the different types of tank and well irrigation. The main sources of irrigation are canals, tanks, and wells. Canals are man-made channels of water taken from a perennial river, dam, or lake to supply water to the agricultural fields. Important canals of Tamil Nadu: Arakankottai Canal, Tadapalli Canal, and Kalingarayan Canal are the major canals of River Bhavani. The Grand Anicut built across the River Kaveri near Trichurappalli diverts the water to the entire Delta region through canals. River Tamiravarani and its tributaries serve Tirunelveli district with many canals. River Tamiravarani has 9 anicuts. Tanks. Lakes are the natural water bodies. Lakes are converted into tanks by strengthening their bunds to store water for irrigation. Ramnathapuram has the maximum number of tanks. Tanks are classified into two in Tamil Nadu. They are system tanks and non-system tanks. System tanks are linked to river or canals, while non-system tanks are dependent on rainfall. Well. Well irrigation utilizes underground water. Well irrigation covers 52% of the irrigated area in the state. Wells are classified into surface wells and tube wells. In this topic, you have learnt the main source of irrigation are canals, tanks, and wells. The Grand Anicut built across the River Kaveri near Trichurappalli diverts the water to the entire Delta region through canals. Lakes are converted into tanks by strengthening their bunds to store water for irrigation. Well irrigation utilizes groundwater. At the end of the topic, you will be able to describe the distribution of food crops in Tamil Nadu, understand the distribution of non-food crops in Tamil Nadu. Each crop requires specific climatic conditions for its growth. All the tropical crops are grown in Tamil Nadu. Food crops. Food crops include cereals, pulses and millets. Paddy is the major food crop cultivated in Tamil Nadu. Kaveri Delta is known as the granary of South India. Paddy is raised in 4 seasons here. Pulses grown in Tamil Nadu are Bengal gram, red gram, green gram, black gram and horse gram. Non-food crops. Non-food crops are cultivated to earn income. Fiber crops include cotton and jute. The major fiber crop of Tamil Nadu is cotton. Commercial crops are sold in the market. Sugarcane, tobacco, oilseeds and spices are commercial crops. Tea, coffee, rubber, pepper and cashew are the main plantation crops of Tamil Nadu. Horticulture. Cultivating fruits and vegetables on large scales is a recent trend in Tamil Nadu. Krishnagiri leads in the production of mango. Thani is known for the grapes cultivation. Animal husbandry. Rearing animals for milk, meat and hide is known as animal husbandry. Avin produces milk and dairy products for the state. The poultry hub of Tamil Nadu is Namakkal, Erode, Coimbatore and Salem. Fisheries. Tamil Nadu ranks 4th in fishing among the states of India. Its long coastline and broad continental shelf favor coastal fishing. In this topic, you have learnt all the tropical crops are grown in Tamil Nadu. Paddy is the major food crop cultivated in Tamil Nadu. The major fiber crop of Tamil Nadu is cotton. Tea, coffee, rubber, pepper, and cashew are the main plantation crops of Tamil Nadu. Cultivating fruits and vegetables on large scales is a recent trend in Tamil Nadu. At the end of the topic, you will be able to understand the changing trends in agriculture, discuss the efforts taken by government to improve agriculture, agricultural development. Before independence, agriculture in Tamil Nadu followed traditional method of cultivation. After independence, there has been a steady development in all aspects of agriculture. Irrigation facilities were improved with the proper implementation of five-year plans in the state. Changing trends in agriculture. The traditional methods of agriculture are slowly being replaced by scientific and technical methods. The Agricultural University in Coimbatore and M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation are trying to fuse traditional and modern methods. Efforts taken by government to improve agriculture. Supply of quality seeds by the government, organic matter and micronutrients are supplied in a subsidized rate. Free electricity for farmers. Government fixes prices for the agricultural products. Farmers market enhances the farmers to get better share of prices. Crop insurance scheme has been introduced. Government has set up agricultural export zones in Nilgiris and Krishnagiri.